God bless you guys. This is Cindy. I just wanted to come on this morning and just give you some encouraging words. And my encouraging word today is from the promises of God. You know, I love reading the word of God because it just renews my mind. It just reminds me that His word is greater than anything that I'm facing. And I encourage you that whatever you're dealing with, go into the word of God and just find promises and stand on those promises. Know that it shall come to pass. God is not a man that He should lie. If He said something, it will happen. You just have to have faith and know that He will perform every single thing that He said He will. So I just want to read a couple of scriptures today, and I pray that this will build your faith. I pray that you will know that God is with you in the midst of the storm, that you won't lose hope, because Christ is our hope. He's our rock. If you're standing on that solid rock, you will not sink. All around you may be sinking sand, but when you stand on that rock, you're going to stand in the midst. If you build your house on the foundation of Christ, it will not fall apart even when the storms come. And that's why I encourage people to build your house on the rock, the cornerstone, Jesus Christ. Have that foundation. When you have a strong foundation, it will not fall apart. But if your foundation is not strong, everything is going to fall apart when the storms come. So know that, you know, it says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, I have become new. Know that when you come to Christ, all your old things have passed away. All your sins are forgiven. I want people to know that once you step into a relationship with God and you go into a covenant with Him, He forgets all your sins. Your old life is gone. You become that new creature in Christ that Christ created you to be. And that's just, you know, a sense of relief, especially that we all fall short every single day. There's none of us that's perfect. We all make mistakes every day, but I thank God that God forgives us. And to know that when He forgives you, He doesn't bring it back up, that's freedom. You know, some of us are in guilt and shame and condemnation, but that is not from God. If you go into a relationship with God and you ask for forgiveness, He doesn't bring it back up. If something or someone brings it back up, know that it's not from God, that He completely forgets it. He puts it in the sea of forgetfulness. So I want you to know today that if you need forgiveness, go to Him. He will forgive you. I encourage you to look at the story of the prodigal son and know that how God forgave his son even when he turned his back on him. And he went out to the world and he noticed that it wasn't anything that he needed. What he needed was with his father. And I love that how his father was waiting patiently for him. And he did not give up hope on his son. He waited for his return. He was standing there waiting. And God is standing and waiting for your return. And He's not mad at you. He's madly in love with you. And I want you to know that. It says in Isaiah 66:12-13, this is what the Lord says, as a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. Know that God wants to comfort you in the midst of the storm. And, you know, even at moments, you know, some of you may be mourning and you may have lost something or lost, you know, a job or lost something that was important. Know that God says in Matthew 5:4, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. God is going to comfort you. Know again in Isaiah 51:12, I am the one who comforts you. So why are you afraid? Do not be afraid. God is going to comfort you in the midst of the storm. Know that He will give you peace, you know, peace that passes all understanding. Happiness is based on our circumstances, but joy comes from the Lord. And when you have true joy, you have peace. And it says in John 16:33, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. God has overcome every single battle. Know that it says in Psalms 34:18, the Lord is close to the brokenhearted. He rescues those whose spirits are crushed. Know that it says in Psalm 145:14, the Lord upholds all who falls and raises up all who are bowed down. Know that God is gonna uphold you even when things start to fall apart. Know that when you have Christ, you don't have to fall apart. Fix your eyes on the things that are above. Fix your eyes and know that if God said it, it's gonna come to pass. You know, His children never go begging for bread. We don't lack anything. You know, we may not have everything we want, but we have everything we need. And I always say, if I have God, then I have it all. You know, this is a season where we just need to check to make sure that we are focusing on the things that matter. Your relationship with God, where's your soul going? Sometimes people don't think about death until you get a little bit older, or until, you know, you get a report that, you know, there's a sickness or something. But every day I think about it, because tomorrow's not guaranteed for anybody. And I want to make sure that my soul is right. I want to make sure that my relationship with God is right. I want to make sure that I'm focusing on the things that really matter. Your family, you know, your loved ones, making an impact, doing everything that God has called you to do. You know, that's one thing that always keeps me in check, is I always ask God, create in me a clean heart, renew my spirit, and make sure that I'm focusing on your agendas. Remove anything that is not of you, and make sure that I am going into divine alignment to what God has called me to do. Because at the end of the day, what I really want to hear, and I know some of you want to hear the same thing, is well done, good and faithful servant. So I want to make sure that I am pleasing the Lord, you know, and I am also fearing the Lord. But when you fear the Lord, it's not being afraid, but honoring him, reverencing him. And, you know, it says in, you know, I think about this, and this is one of my favorite scriptures. And when I was a little girl, this was one of the first Psalms that I memorized, and it was from Psalm 23. And one of my favorite quotes, or, you know, verses from Psalm 23, and I encourage you to go to Psalm 23. But it says, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you are beside me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort and protect me. Know that even though you're walking through maybe dark, God is with you. Do not be afraid. You know, I always think about Psalm 46, 10 and 11. It says, he says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Know that God is with you. Sometimes we just need to be still and know that he is God. You know, this is a season where we're going to know that we have no control. But I know the one that has control. And I know the one that has me in the palm of his hands. And even when the mist where anxiety or depression tries to knock on your door, you need to shut that door by faith. When fear knocks on your door, shut that door by faith. And how do you shut that door? Renewing your mind, saying your scriptures, and being bold. Confess with your mouth. Life and death is in your tongue. And this is why I tell people, you know, confess the promises of God. Stand on the promises during this season of your life. Know that it says in Psalm 147:3, the Lord heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. God is going to bind up your wound. Anything that comes to hurt you, God is going to bind it up. He's going to heal you. He came to heal the brokenhearted. He came to heal the sick. He came to be your provider. He came to forgive you of your sins. Know that he is available. Every time I tell people he's available, because when I was broken, when I was lost, he was the only thing that got me through. You know, people are great and they will be there for you, but it's nothing like when you have God by your side. He is the one that's going to shield you. He's the one that's going to protect you. And I want you to know today that God loves you. I want you to know today that put your hope in Christ. I want you to know that if you don't have a relationship with him, that he's available. I want you to know that he has not forgotten you. Even when there are moments that we may forget him, he's like a father waiting for his children. You know, even as me as a mother in the natural, no matter what my kids do, I love them. And I can't imagine the unconditional love that God has for us. And I just feel it really heaven in my heart that some of you are feeling like God is mad at you, that he's trying to punish you. God doesn't do that. Let me remind you today that God loves you. He loves you more than anyone on this earth could ever love you. And that he died on that cross so that we could come back into relationship with him. And I want you to know that he's available. You know, all you have to do is go and say a prayer. Ask God to forgive you. Change your heart. Repent. You know, and then once you repent and come into relationship with Christ, read your Bible, get into a church, a Bible-believing church, get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, and receive the Holy Spirit. I always think about Acts 2:38, and I've loved the book of Acts because that's when the church was birthed, and we are the church. I always tell people all the time, but there's a message of hope, and even at moments when you can't get into the church, know that your home can be the church. You know, a lot of people think that you need to be in the church to receive Christ. I was in my home when I received Christ. I was in my home when I was broken, and I asked God to come into my life because it was at my darkest moment when I was in my miscarriage and I was alone and nobody was there. It was Christ that was there for me. It was in my home that I received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. So I want you to know that your home could be your sanctuary. God is with you anywhere, everywhere. It doesn't have to be in a church. And you know when that deep connection is when you're alone with God. And this is a season where many of us are alone, but know that God is in the midst with you. And know that He wants to talk to you. He still speaks. You know how He speaks? It's in the Word of God. I open up this book. This is the book that got me through. It's the Bible. And yeah, it looks all messy and this is all my stuff. But, you know, sometimes it's important to write your messages in there. I look back and I look at dates that God did things for me. I go back and, you know, I write down things and know that He's my Abba. He's my Father. And, you know, it sometimes is a place for us to remember that God doesn't fail us. I even have like pictures in there. When, you know, I got pregnant and I would look at the miss and, you know, people would give you negative reports, but I remember the reports of the Lord. And even as I'm going through it, I even remember moments when it was dark for me, but God was my light. And I just encourage you, every time I look at my Bible, I know that God is with me and nothing can defeat us if you have Christ in your life. So today I encourage you, get back in your word, come back into a relationship with Christ, pray. Seek Him and know that He is just a prayer away. Cry out. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. God knows our hearts. God knows what we need even before we ask Him. And you know, man looks on the outside, but God looks on our hearts. So today, I encourage you, just be blessed. God bless you.